it's me, Stormy, and just before you watch this video, I saw that we just hit 55,000 subscribers, so yay! I just wanted to come on really quickly and thank you guys so much, and if you are new to the channel, welcome, welcome, welcome to the tribe. If you've been here forever and ever since the beginning, thank you so much for sticking with me. I look forward to growing and continuing to study and educate on this channel and learn from you guys as well. And as always, every time we get to a milestone, there is a subscriber gift, so keep your eyeballs open for it and make sure you check the community tab for the link to that as well. Okay, I don't want to keep you from your video, but thank you guys so much, and congratulations to you guys as well on 55,000 subscribers on this channel, because it just means the tribe is getting bigger and better. All right, you guys, I love you so much. Enjoy the video. Hello, my beautiful friends. I hope you're doing wonderfully out there. In this video, we're going to talk about the full moon that is coming up this coming week, May 18th at 27 degrees of Scorpio. And what a delicious moon. If you've been listening to videos on this channel, you know I've been pretty excited about it, because I think that this particular full moon not only gives us some drive and some help to get some things done, we have to uncover some emotions, we have to look at some things from the past, but this particular moon is showing us what's in the way of us achieving our deepest desires, or just achieving what we're desiring to get done. So this is going to be a very interesting moon, I think, for many of us. And of course, it's astrology. So some people, depending on how your chart is laid out, you may feel like you have a little bit less of an impact with this particular moon. And some people will definitely feel it more intensely. So first things first, just so you know, if you do happen to have any of your personal planets between 22 and 30 degrees of any of the fixed energies, which are Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, and Aquarius, it's talked about down here in the corner in this bottom right-hand corner, or you happen to have a heavy water chart, so your primary element is water in your chart, this moon may be a little bit more intense for you, just because of the way things line up and where the intensities will hit, okay? So we're gonna jump in here and we're gonna talk all about what's happening at this moon, the aspects that we see, what you can do with it, and why any of this matters in the first place. Before I jump into that, I do wanna let you know down here in the bottom, oh, that was in the bottom left-hand corner over there, down over here in the bottom right-hand corner, what we've got going on is an opportunity for some upcoming learning sessions that I've got going on in June. So June 9th, I'm going to be doing a birth chart for beginners class. So if you've got your birth chart, you don't really know what to do with it, or you've got it, but you don't really understand it, I'm going to teach you the four major points you need to know to break that thing down and kind of understand what you're looking at. On June 19th and the 23rd is going to be a practice session. If you're a little bit more advanced in your astrology work, we're going to be breaking down and interpreting a natal chart in one session and a transit chart in the other. So if you'd like to sign up, space is limited because it can't be these huge classes, and I'll never be able to actually learn and teach with you. So if you're ready to practice your skills or you want to learn something else, these sessions are up and available. You can click in the description box down below and get signed up, okay? All right, let's jump into this big, bona fide, beautiful chart that we've got going. So we do have the full moon that's going to be happening. It's right here at 27 degrees of Scorpio. So if you happen to have something in your chart at 22 to 30 degrees of Scorpio, or one of the fixed signs, you're going to want to definitely check that out. So the full moon tells us that we need to end something, we need to acknowledge something, or we need to make an adjustment to something of some variety. And it tends to pull at us on a deeper emotional level as well, because we have to reveal some emotions. We have to reveal some unconscious, subconscious things so that they can rise to the surface. We can see them and then we can deal with them. We can take action to dismiss them. So this particular moon is going to be absolutely no different. Now, in the energy of Scorpio, we have to think about how Scorpio kind of does business, right? It's a very emotional sign. It's a water energy, but it's not just wild out emotion, right? Scorpio wants to keep those emotions close because we want to keep them under control, right? I want to have power. I want to have control over these emotions. So I'm not going to just have them laying out all over the place. They're certainly not going to be spread all over the place. So these are things that maybe you've already had in your life. You've been dealing with them. It's a trauma from the past. You have to face a hurt. You have to face something that was maybe painful from your past. And as this full moon is coming up, it's bringing it to light in the most healthy way possible, right? It's in a safe way to process and look at this with this particular full moon under that Scorpio energy. Now, Scorpio is also a deep energy, right? So we are going to get to the root of whatever needs to be seen here in this particular area. Now, at a full moon, the biggest aspect that is important that we know we're having a full moon is that the moon and the sun are going to be in opposition to each other. So they're on opposite sides of each other, right? So the sun is over here at 27 degrees of Taurus. So this Taurus energy over here is delicious. It's very earthy. It's a very grounded energy, and it's sitting in opposition to the energy of Scorpio, highlighting our opposite needs, our polarities, our needs versus our wants, my keeping things versus my surrendering things, whatever it is at this particular moon that sits in polarity to what you've got going on, that's what you're going to be definitely looking at and highlighting. Now, one of the things that I think is a huge polarity that we're looking at with this particular moon, with this aspect, is that the Scorpio moon is all about emotions. The Taurus sun is all about the body, right? It's a very tangible thing. You can touch the body, you can feel it, you can use your five senses to figure things out. But when we're dealing with the opposite of that, it's the Scorpio energy that's not tangible. We can't touch it. We feel it, we sense it. It's these things. So where is this place where these two things are in opposition for you? Have you not been dealing with a health concern? Have you not been dealing with a past relationship and instead you're internalizing this? Well, that won't work anymore. This full moon is going to help to draw that out. Now, in addition to being in just opposition to this particular sun-moon combination, this time we've got a buddy on board with the sun. So we've got the sun and Mercury here in conjunction with each other, and then in opposition to this moon. So how this changes this is that Mercury is our planet of conversation. We want to talk about things. We want to discuss things. We want to discuss things of value. We need to communicate, right? And we've got this full moon saying, bring it up. Bring it up to the surface. It might be emotional. It might be painful. It might be wonderful. Bring it to the surface, and now we are going to acknowledge it, and we're going to talk about it, right? So there will be communication, and it is so powerfully good because whatever is coming up, the other aspect that we have got going on is that the moon is also in a brilliant sextile to Pluto over here, right? So these two energies over here are working together. Now, the moon being in a sextile to Pluto, first of all, when the planets have sex, that's good for us because it's a pocket of opportunity that you are going to take intelligent advantage of. And to Pluto, the energy of transformation, what this is giving you is drive. This is not a particularly like strong aspect at this particular moon, but it's a good one. It's a good one. It gives you drive. It gives you motivation to get things done. It's a very positive influence on this moon because it tells me that whatever you are seeing, whatever is coming up, whatever is being presented to you is something that you're ready and you have the resources to deal with to either end, acknowledge, or make an adjustment to. And the thing you're going to make this adjustment, the reason you will, is because it is standing in your way of your deepest desires, the thing that you want to do or have or be the most. Whatever is going to be presented at this moon is standing in the way, and you have to see it, and you have to acknowledge with this energy that you cannot stay the same. Nothing stays the same. Change is critical to your transformation, and this moon helps you be ready to let it go. Now, we've also got a couple other aspects. I want to just go back for just a second. With the Sun-Mercury conjunction that we've got here, the Sun's bringing light, heat, life, vitality, right? Mercury's bringing communication. So in the communications that will be happening, they're vibrant, right? You're ready to speak. There's some passion. There's some fire behind it, but it's steady, sturdy, practical, just like the energy of Taurus. Now, both Taurus and Scorpio are fixed energies. So where you maybe have had the same idea, the same conversation, you've been saying and thinking and believing the same thing for a very long time, these these energies actually get a little bit of help because we've got Venus and Uranus over here in conjunction with each other as well. And they're bringing an element of surprise. Maybe it's like surprise to your money, surprise to your relationship, surprise to your thinking, right? So it's an energy that definitely has a powerful influence to change the way you're doing something. As you can see, these energies are also interacting nicely up there with Mars, which is your energy, your planet, and your energy of action. So at this full moon, we've got revelation that's happening. We've got you being willing to accept or to see what is happening, what's in the way of your deepest desires that you're trying to achieve, and some new surprising actions that you can take to bring resolution to these things. It's an absolutely brilliant kind of energy that we see playing out in the aspects. So remember that, first of all, whatever comes up for you during this moon, because it is positively aspected, you're prepared. You're ready to see this. You're ready to see how you are standing in your own way and welcome some transformation. Now, if you fight against this moon, or if you fight against the transformation, of course, that will be a little bit more complicated. But whatever it is you have maybe been holding back at, not wanting to see, not wanting to look at, not wanting to step into paying that debt, not wanting to release being a victim in that relationship, right? Because in the energy of the opposition between Scorpio and Taurus, we can have this victim mentality that shows up as well. So where do you get to stop being in that victim mentality at this particular moon and instead own it? Own your power, own your story, own your drama, frame people around you who have been through similar situations and can teach you to walk through them so that you can do, have, be, and become whatever it is that you are desiring to be, so that you can clean out that spiritual closet that we've all got going on, that emotional closet we've all got going on. Where do you need a little spring cleaning and culmination with this full moon? So I think it's going to be a really nice moon. I think it is very useful. I'm just so excited as we're coming, getting ready to come into the eclipse season in just a couple months here. If you will clear a path, if you will work with these energies, when we get to this next shift of the eclipses, you will have different visions. It's like a new pair of glasses, a new perspective at your life, your challenges, your situations, your development that you can work off of, that you can come up with and use the Uranian energy to bring brand new, innovative, intuitive solutions into your life to these things that have been kind of holding you down for probably a very long time, or fears that you've just been holding on to for a very long time. And I can tell you that for some of you, that means stepping into this job, this career, this skill that you've had, that you've been too afraid to actually go out and turn into something profitable or just even share with people. So this particular moon, I think, is going to be brilliant for pulling us all out of hiding a little bit. So try and enjoy this moon. Let me know where this is happening for you in your chart. And remember, as always, this is a general reading. So you want to line up your chart, look at where this is falling, what house is it falling in for you, and then you'll be able to tell which major area is going to be affected for you. And I hope you will come learn and study with me in June before I get married. And we can talk all about astrology, get you started, get you understanding that birth chart, and let you practice if your skills have been developing and now you would just kind of like a lifeguard to be on duty. So I hope to see you guys very, very soon. Like this video, comment, share, subscribe if you found it helpful, valuable. You see any good happening in this video, please let me know. And definitely let me know what's happening for you in the comment section down below, okay? All right, you guys, I love you and I'll see you next time. Bye.